If you said anything yet, people are laughing. This is fantastic.
Hold on. Okay. So I just don't know how to drag my brother. I've known Travis longer than that, so we're probably family for later. Anyways, and I'd like to thank everybody for coming in today, and I'd like to welcome Travis into the family. So Travis, welcome to the family after, was it 14, 13 years or something like that? Welcome to the family.
All right, I think that's it.
That's not it.
Oh, there was another person, wasn't there?
Tracy first.
Oh, okay, speech of the bridesmaids, sorry. And then we got two people coming up to talk for the groomsmen. Takes two of them to talk for the groomsmen.
That's not true.
That's what's written here, but I did do my own notes.
Well, it's true, there it is.
All right, well, welcome, Tracy. Tracy Howard.
Good evening, everyone. I hope everybody's enjoying this beautiful day. To anyone who doesn't know me, I'm Tracy, good friends with the bride. I'm so honored to be a part of this special day and wish you both the best of many years ahead. So after 13 years and a very, very stressful few months, this day has finally come. You both look amazing tonight. Ashley, you are my best friend and truly the most beautiful bride. You are funny, smart, caring, and brutally honest. I'm so lucky to have such an amazing person in my life. Travis, you have chosen a wonderful woman to be your wife, and all I ask is that you take good care of her and always keep her laughing. So now that the hard part is over and these beautiful people are married, let's help them celebrating the start of their new journey as husband and wife. Please raise your glasses to the new wedding. May the happiness you feel tonight be the start of a wonderful and happy marriage. Ashley and Travis, I love you both. Congratulations.
Follow that!
So I'd like to welcome Jeremy Burr and Ryan Rogers and toast to their room.
Bottle that right. Bottle
that right.
Get
up. I'll come later. I'll come later. You gotta go now.
Oh, now stand up, everybody gives a speech. Yeah.
Yeah. Your seats. He popped the collar and everything.
This is going to be epic, everybody.
You gotta make the mic higher.
We don't have a mic big enough.
Raise it up.
Excuse me. I don't have this. Shut up.
I need not know what that.
First, I'd like to apologize for any burping or miscommunication words. I'm very nervous. I'm not drinking. Pretty sure I'm keeping myself in a bit.
He wrote this one over at 8 o'clock this morning.
What?
Nice.
So I had a little speech written here, and I might fill in the blanks, so I'm reading back and forth. It might not make sense. If you can hear me, raise your hand.
Can you see? You no. Can't hear him, raise your hand. I'll sit next to you.
All right. Good evening. First of all, I'd like to say that Ashley, you look beautiful. Travis, use some work. In case anyone was wondering, I'm Jeremy. I'm Travis' best friend. When Travis asked me to be his best man at the last moment, I'm like, my dad. Yesterday. I made it short and sweet. I've known Travis actually roughly 12 or 13 years. And I remember the first time I met him. I walked to his house and walked to the living room and seen him very really nervous, very antisocial. Lost in a room and Travis actually was blind day with I think some friends. And all around the room was like speakers, computers, video games, and I think they were playing something. And next thing I thought was, I want to be a friend. The first thing Travis said was, don't make sure you're okay, don't hit the fan. Talk. You guys are great. You're into like video games, sports. Drinking, games, video games, music, everything. Like, the whole package, both of you. And I don't think Cupid himself will make a better match than you guys. I'm not sure what else to say.
How do you not say it?
The one that missed one sheet of paper. All right, for next part, I'd like to have my best man, who's taking care of me all this is the part of that, Lauren Rogers, come on.
First, talk about the whole Pepsi thing first.
All right. Both me and Ron are really surprised that, well, the thing is, Travis married Ashley because couldn't marry Pepsi. Those things love Pepsi.
Because Pepsi is not the person.
Exactly. It's not legal in Canada right now. So we're in these days. So we got Pepsi here and we're on a toast.
We're gonna make
sure
a toast with Pepsi.
I thought we would share a bottle,
make
more than that.
We can!
Alright, so here's toast to Bride and Groom. Bride and Ashley.
Raise your glasses.
Or Pepsi. I got Pepsi. Or Pepsi.
A wedding day will be remembered for all joy it brings. A day of love and happiness, of daggers and wedding rings. A day of new beginnings, learning what love truly means. Your wedding day is just the start to many hopes and dreams. Cheers.
You wrote that this morning.
What happened to my girlfriend over there?
No, you can pass it down. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're all family now.
I'm not famous. Over here.
No one's drinking. No one's drinking from the Pepsi.
People
are
drinking.
Drink it.
No.
Brought all I need
them. Do you drink out of it?
No. Nope. That was the first one, so it looks bad for me. Drink it. Drink it.
What you got in it?
Pepsi.
I'm not
going to
remember the rest of the night, am I?
You don't have to drink it all.
That's sodium and caffeine, buddy. You're good.
Good. That's
not. Oh my god. None of the girls drank it, right? Not one girl.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Mr. Councilman, Jason Perry, yes.
Stick around for as long as you have one. Cheers.
Thank you.